Notion just released a brand new database property called Buttons. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the new Buttons property to build this time tracker for your project and task management system. This LifeOS dashboard, which I'll be using in this video, has been updated with this time tracker, which you can find as the first link in the description. Now let's get started. So what is this new Notion update? Well, in a nutshell, it's a new property that we can add to our Notion database that works the same as the Notion buttons, except you can also edit and change the individual properties of this database. So for example, I can add an action to this button property that will mark the task as complete, and I can also add in done as the button name. So now if I click on this button, it will automatically mark the task as complete. And now on the database view, I can go into properties and I can hide the done checkbox property and show the button property. And I can just use this button to mark the task as complete. And just like the normal buttons, you can also add in more steps after this one. So you can edit more properties, or you can add another step. You can add pages to other databases, edit pages, show the confirmation, open the page, or edit more of this database properties. There's so much you can do with this new property, but in this video, we'll just be focusing on building a time tracker for your projects and task management system. What you want to do is go to your task database, open up a database entry, and then click on add a new property. The first property we're going to add is going to be a date property, which we're going to call start date. Then we're going to add another property, which is going to be for our enter date. Once you've got these two properties, you can add your button property, which is going to be called start log. For this property, we're going to add a play button for the icon, and for the action, we're going to edit the start date, and we're going to select the dynamic now option. Then you're going to add another button property, which is going to be for the end log. For this property, we're going to add the stop icon, and for the action, we're going to select the end date property, and we're going to select the dynamic now option. So now if we click on start log, it will add a date and time for the start date property, and the same goes for the end log. But now what we need is a formula that shows us the total time spent on this task. To do this, we're first going to need three separate formula properties. The first formula is going to be for the total minutes elapsed. So for this formula, we want to see the total minutes between the end and start date. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a date between function, select the end date, and select the start date with a comma in between, and then another comma and specify that we want the minutes. Then if we click on done and change the end date so it's different from the start date, you'll now see the total minutes in between these two date properties. Now what we're going to do is we're going to duplicate this property. We're going to change the name to hours elapsed. And then for this formula, we want to specify that we want the total hours. Then if we click on done, you'll now see the total hours. Now we're going to do this one more time, but this time it's going to be for the total days. So again, inside of the formula, just specify that we want to see the total days. If you want to learn everything about the new Notion formulas, then just check out my Formula 2.0 playlist through the card above or in the description below. Now let's add our main formula property, which is going to be for the total time tracked. For this formula, we're going to start off with an ifs function that basically just says if this, then that. So the first one is going to be if the total minutes elapsed is zero, then show nothing. Otherwise, if the total minutes elapsed is 1, then show the total minutes elapsed plus text that says minute with a space in the front. Otherwise, shift enter. If the minutes elapsed is less than 60, then show the total minutes elapsed plus text that says minutes, plural. Otherwise, if the total hours elapsed is 1, then show the total hours elapsed plus text that says hour. Otherwise, if the hours elapsed is less than 24, then show the total hours elapsed plus text that says hours. Otherwise, if the days elapsed is greater than 1, then show the total days elapsed plus text that says days. Otherwise, if the days elapsed is 1, then show the total days elapsed plus text that says day. If we click on done, you'll see that the text says 1 hour. And we can move it to the future, and you'll see that it will update depending on the time in between the end and the start date. But this looks very boring, so let's add some aesthetics. Next to our text, we're going to add a style function, and we're going to make it bold, add a comma, and then make the color red. Then we're simply going to copy the style function and paste it next to all the other texts. Now, if we click on done, you'll see that the number is still white, but the text is now red. Now the next thing we need to do for our formula is that if we mark our task as complete, the color of the text will change to green. So let's open up this formula, and then at the beginning of everything, just shift and enter. And then I'm also going to highlight this and click on tab. to just move it one tab over. And then I'm going to add a normal if function. I'm going to remove the closing bracket, and then I'm going to add the closing bracket at the very end of the formula. For this if function, I'm going to say if the done checkbox property is false, aka the task is not complete, then show all of this that we just created. Otherwise, and then what we're about to create now. Now I'm also going to add a comment here at the top just to organize and clean up this formula. And then I'm going to copy this comment and then just paste it into the completed section and then just change this to completed section. So what we're going to do is we're literally just going to copy all of this and then just paste it inside of the completed section. But now for the completed section, we're going to remove all of these style functions. And then I'm going to add this whole section inside of brackets. And then I'm going to add a style function to this entire completed section. And I'm going to make it bold as well as change the color to green. Now, if I click on done, you'll see that it's now green. And if I uncheck this, you'll see that it changed back to red. Now, another thing you can do is in the beginning of your completed section, you can add in a emoji inside of quotation marks. Add a space, close off the quotation marks, and then add a plus in order for an emoji to show up once your task is complete. Now, once all of this is done, you can click on the minutes, hours, and days elapsed properties, go to property visibility, and click on always hide. And then you can simply click on this hide properties button to hide them from your view. And then I'd recommend to just move the time track to the top and then move all three of the date properties to the bottom. And now on your database, you can now go to your database menu, click on properties, and then here you can show the time tracked formula as well as the start log and end log buttons. And then you simply reorder them. So just move the done checkbox property to the bottom and the time tracked formula to the top. Now I can exit out of this database menu and I can use the end log and start log buttons to see how many minutes, hours, or days I've been working on this task. And if you want to do the same thing for your calendar view, then just repeat the same process. Go inside of your database menu, go to properties, and then just show the two button properties as well as the time tracked formula, and then just reorder everything as you want it. So now I can track my time directly on my calendar view. Now, obviously, there are a lot of different ways to use the new Notion buttons, and if you want me to create a video on anything specific, then just comment it down below. Be sure to give this video a like. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.